You remember the day that George W. Bush pretended to pilot a fighter jet onto the deck of USS Abraham Lincoln, wearing a flight suit. He then changed into a regular pantsuit and stood under a banner declaring mission accomplished for the war in Iraq. At that point, the war in Iraq was 1 month old. On that same exact day, May 1st, 2003, First Lieutenant Paul Rykoff and his platoon received their orders to ship out to Baghdad. Lieutenant Rykoff ended up in house-to-house fighting as an infantry platoon leader in Iraq. When he returned home in 2004, he founded the first organization representing veterans of the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. The first name for the group was Operation Truth, but it soon became Iraq and Afghanistan Veterans of America, IAVA. IAVA is the first and the largest organization for post-9/11 vets in this country. When our country began those gigantically long wars in the first term of the Bush presidency, there was a lot of uncertainty as to how the unpopularity, particularly of the Iraq War, might affect our nation's treatment of the Americans who were sent to fight in it. But over all these years now, IAVA has helped settle that uncertainty and has made sure that vets themselves have the strongest possible voice in answering that question. It has been 14-plus years of backbreaking work, fighting the huge early backlogs on disability claims at a VA that was not ready for all those young vets when those wars just didn't end. Dragged on and on and on, despite the mission accomplished banners 1 month in. IAVA is the reason we got a new post-9/11 GI Bill. IAVA was absolutely instrumental in the repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell. IAVA has done the harrowing work of trying to stop veterans' homelessness and suicide and waking the country up to the magnitude of those two crises. Paul Rykoff founded IAVA at the start, right after he himself was back from Iraq. He's been at the helm as founder and CEO all these years. Well, this week, he's announced that he is moving on after 14-plus years and all of this work. He says he'll stay on the board, but he is no longer going to lead this group that he founded that absolutely changed U.S. history in terms of how our generation of veterans is treated in this country and how they speak for themselves and for each other. So congratulations to Lieutenant Rykoff, and Godspeed to everybody at IAVA from here on out. We need you guys more than ever.